Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Aven Colony. And on tonight's episode, we are going to be continuing where we left off. Now, for those of you who may have missed the last few episodes, what we actually ended up doing was going through Azura Falls on Insane and finally finishing that one up. That was pretty difficult, but on this one, we're going to be going through Hylas's Crescent and seeing if we can beat it. Now, this one says that the area supports vast amount of cultivation, but the mineral deposits are meager at best. So right off the bat, that tells me we're going to need to go ahead and build the facilities to create more nanites through food, through using the kelp coal sludge. And I think the best method through doing that one is to, right off the bat, concentrate on getting a research center in. Maybe not so many people, because we don't really need the added, population to be taking more food. We want those farms to be going towards the cocoa sludge. So without any further ado, guys, we're going to get into this one and see just how difficult it is. Now, I did get a lot of requests for sandbox mode, and we will be going through sandbox mode. We have this crescent to get through, and then we have the last level that is still in the game at the moment to get through on Insane, and then we will be going into sandbox modes on certain maps. So leave your votes on what maps you want to see in sandbox mode the most, and we will be playing those first. We will be trying every single one of them in sandbox mode eventually and seeing just how big we can make them. All right, so let's take a look at what we have here. We have an air overlay. Let's actually go to pause real quick. Now, it has been a little while since I played the level. I do try to give them a couple weeks in between when I shoot my videos so that there is a chance they could add more stuff to the game. They haven't added anything yet, but I know they're busy at work and trying to do that. So let's take a look at resource overlay. So we have some energy right here, right next to us. That is fantastic. We definitely will use that. We also have some iron deposits. Only 275 iron right off the bat in each one of those. That is not a whole lot of iron, so I probably will only end up building one processing plant for both of those mines right there, and I probably won't even upgrade those mines past tier one or maybe tier two. We got some more iron over here, 350. That's not too terribly horrible. We have what is this, a little bit of nanites, rice, and corn. I don't think food's gonna be too bad of a deal. We do have some more geothermal vents, some bread, some gold, and some nanites. Now, we do have a choice. Do we go left or do we go right? So let's see what is over here on the right-hand side. These are geothermal vents. Definitely going to be useful for energy consumption, and I think we'll probably have to go to those more often, or go to them a little faster than we probably would want to otherwise. There is one over here, so maybe we will save those for last. We got some iron deposits, 450, that's not too bad. Some potash deposits over here, yeah, 1,800 a piece. That's going to be fantastic. Let's see, cargo pod, 30 nanites, 60 vodka. We don't really use those too often. Man, there is a lot of geothermal vents over here. Iron deposit, we finally got some zorium deposits, 5,000, at least they're not skimping on that one. And then if you really, really can get all the way out here, you got a little bit more iron to go as well. So let's zoom out a little bit. And I think we're going to be heading all the way over here. That's the quest anyway. So you can see the progression it wants you to go. This is the route it wants you to lead off into. But we do kind of want to go off in that direction for the energy alone. So let's go ahead and start planning our direction. I think we're going to go straight ahead this way. And then we'll split one area off that way and one area off that way. But at least we're right down the center of it when we do start building off. So we need to click off of this. We need to get some iron mines going right off the bat. So let's go ahead and put those down. Let's get this. We also need to get some energy going as well. But I do kind of want the iron mines going a little bit sooner than that. Let's see. Where is our iron? Right here. No, it's the other one. Let's do mine one. And mine one. Will it give me enough? How much did I start with? Let's actually put down the energy first, just in case, because I would hate to run out. Geothermal generator right there. Let's put down some roads, get it connected. Nope, like that, and one more. And can we do another mine? We need to do a nanite processor before we get anything else done. A mine right there. Okay, let's go ahead and put it on slow. And we need to put some food and some water down before we do any other progressions through this. So let's do some water. Let's find a good spot for that. Pretty much anywhere on the map is going to be good for water. Doesn't seem like that's going to be a hard spot. So let's go ahead and put some water right here. And we do need to put like air vents and things of that sort, but again, one step at a time. We do need to put some of this down. So we need 8 power. We have 41 nanites, so I could move these a little bit away from where we're at, or I could leave them right where they're at over here next to our base somewhere. I think I will move them down just a couple. Not too much. I don't want to waste too many nanites. We have a lot of things we need to buy. So barley's not going to be all that great. Broccoli's not too bad. What about corn? Corn's okay. What about melons? Melons is always fantastic. That's just, I think that we're going to be going with melons to start with. 4.8. You know, corn's not too bad either, but I want melons. Melons is going to be where it's at. So let's do these out here. I do want to leave some room for my housing over here at some point, so we're going to leave that alone. And we're going to tell these guys to start doing these first. Get this stuff done. And start connecting these things to a road. Hopefully he does the roads before he goes back and tries to do the other buildings over there. You know, we are kind of going a little fast, so let's go ahead and take out the mission, slow it down a little bit, hopefully not run out of anything too quickly.
Your colonists have been informed of your arrival and are eager to see what their leader can do for them.
All right, we have identified the presence of an unknown object here on Hylas Crescent. While the mineral deposits at this location are barely adequate, this area is excellent for building an agricultural colony. After we extend the colony out, towards the other end of the lake, we can acquire the object using construction drones. This will be a very large colony. Let's begin by adding a second solar panel. All right, so it wants a second solar panel. I don't quite have enough for that. That's 12 nanites, so I do have to wait until it at least does this stuff. Now, it does have to connect the roads before I can start making any nanites off of that, so that's kind of a little bit of a downside right there. Come on, dude, you know you can do it. And the area is absolutely beautiful. I mean, look at that, guys. That is the scenery on this world. So if you were staying in a hotel or one of those giant skyscraper apartments, you would have this beautiful, beautiful scenery. Now, I did read some of the patch notes, and they said that eventually they are going to make it where these little buildings right here, these storage modules, the ones that they start you with, can be recycled and removed from the game so that you can do your own thing. I do like that idea. They do kind of get in the way after you start progressing through the game a little bit, and you're just like, oh, you know, I wish I could use that space for something else. This one's not going to be so much because they're down here on the bottom, and we're going to be going that way the whole time. So these are kind of just where they're at, and that's not going to be that big of a deal. But remember, you are playing on insane, and insane means they want everything. Police, entertainment like nobody's business. They don't just want one form of entertainment. They want every form of entertainment, and they want it right next to them all the time. They also have to protect themselves from the what do they call them? Their scrubbers is what you need to protect yourself from them, but I think they were I can't even remember the name of the alien race that is coming in, but you gotta watch out for them. They're kind of more of a oddity than a nuisance at the moment. In fact, I think the biggest nuisance is the lightning. You know, that just has to be the number one. But they are coming out with lightning rods that will eventually stop that from happening. And once you get the auto drone repair unit, then, you know, the lightning isn't too big of a deal unless it's destroying your roads or your tunnels. And then it becomes a little bit more of an annoyance. But lightning rods on the way. I'm just looking forward to them. I know they're coming, and once they do, we're all going to be happy about it. So let's go ahead and put down our little reactor thing over here, the solar panel. I'm going to tell him to come back over here and do that right off the bat, because that is going to give me some rewards. 2 nanites and 2 corn, but more importantly, it's going to open me up to more quest in a minute. And I think some of the quests they're going to be giving me are stuff that I've already done. So that's just going to be free resources right off the bat. So I wanted to get that done as soon as possible. And he's almost done with it too. That doesn't really take very long. It's one of the most simple buildings you can possibly build. The one downside that I've seen to the solar panels, they do create a fair bit of lag in the game when you have a lot of them, because they actually rotate to the sun, wherever it is on the map. If you're looking, you know, around the map right now, you can kind of see, I think the sun is almost directly overhead of us at the moment. And you got to remember, we are going to be entering a winter here. I think I can come in here and I can do rationing. I might have to put rationing on because we're pretty low on food at the moment. He's not even close to getting over here to build the greenhouse yet. I haven't even put down a immigration center yet, and we definitely will need the immigration center so we can start getting some troops in, some people in. And we also need an apartment because these things get filled up incredibly quickly. And in fact, if I put my housing overlay on, you can see there's probably not a whole lot of housing available. This is the only one, right? 16 out of 16, that's it. So we have no room for more housing, unfortunately. Yeah, 100% of housing used. So I need to improve that. But there's no point in creating more housing if you don't have an immigration center, because nobody else will come in without that ability. And that's kind of unfortunate that you have to do that.
The colony could benefit from a higher level of food output.
All right, before we can extend the colony further, we will need to increase our food income. If you hover over the food indicator, it should tell you the current food production in units per colonist per hour. Build any combination of farms and greenhouses until you reach 10 food per hour. We get 9 beer out of that. Well, that's not going to happen anytime soon. 13.6 colonists, 13.5 per colonist per hour. I think we're already there, right? We just need 10? And we also finished 2 quests off here. We got 2 nanites, 2 candy for doing the water supply. So that was something we already had done. And then, of course, building a solar panel, we got 2 nanites and 2 corn. So as soon as this thing is done and we get some people working in, we should be able to do that. Now let's look at the colony immigration center. That's 25 nanites. So let's go ahead and step it up just a little bit on the speed. Remember, when you first get started, that's the most crucial time. That's where everything can go wrong. If you don't plan it out right, if you go too fast, you go too slow, things are going to go very, very badly. And then you're going to get to a plateau stage where you have a little bit of resources to work with. And if you don't go the right direction there, you're going to lose as well. So only on insane, though, that it is really that difficult. Oh, great. We're going to have winter coming here pretty soon. Winter approaches. Impaired power generation and food cultivation. So we just finally got this up. We got somebody inside. One guy. One girl, actually. 16% efficiency. We're getting 1.2 melons an hour. Fall growth 100%. 100% irrigation. And 0.2 water per hour. So that's not too bad. You can see right here we're at 11.3. 11.1. We need to raise that up quite a bit, but I need to get this thing in soon. And then once I get this thing in, I need to put in an apartment, a little crappy, tiny, you know, I hate to use the word crappy because it's really not that bad, but it's not that great either. And then later down the road, you can replace those, get rid of them, demolish them, whatever you want to do. Usually it's better for your people if you do that too, unless they're just not happy because they're too far away from their work. Then putting closer buildings, whether they're smaller or larger near those areas, can sometimes make them happy too. 25 nanites, come on, come on, you're almost there. There you go. Immigration center. We're going to go ahead and stick that, let's stick that right here. Yeah, I kind of like that. We'll stick that right there. We'll still have room on both sides. Let's see, warning level, food is low. Okay, well, then we're going to go into colony, and we're going to go into rationing. Probably a little too late to do it. I mean, that's, we still have a long winter to get through. So, may not be able to make it through this, but, that sucks. We had a good start, at least. I should have put that on when I saw it earlier, but I was like, no, I don't want to make them mad. This is a planet that's going to have plenty of food. What's the chances we're going to run out of food this soon?
Situation in your colony. Hunger appears to be a growing problem.
I get it.
Is everything all right down there?
No, everything is not all right. I mean, I'm going to get more people here in a minute, which means more mouths to feed, but that means more people working in my greenhouse, which means more food. So hopefully they even out. But until that happens, we still need 18 nanites. So let's go ahead and speed that up just a tad bit more. Until we get those 18 nanites, not much is going to happen here. Let's see, dropship descending. 3 new colonists per trip. Nowhere to stay, so they're not going to stay down here for very long. Let's see, 10 nanites. Come on, guys. You know you want to go to work. Just not enough people to do anything, unfortunately. Let's see, they still have iron to process, so they're processing a little slower than they could. If I sped that up a little bit, if I upgraded it, we might do a little bit better on the job, but we need to concentrate on what's important. 18 nanites right here. Get those people in here, and hopefully they go to the food. Right off the bat, that's the only place they need to be going, is to make more food and get those jobs going. Now, the area is pretty slummy. There's no air filters in this area right now. There's no police, there's no entertainment. You know, they're going to be demanding that fairly soon. So the fact that they want food, yeah, I get it, but they're also going to be wanting other stuff. So I also have to start thinking about that. But food is our first priority, and it's the one that we can't live without. Let's see where are you guys coming in from in just a minute. We got 16 people capacity max. Average health 99%. Average happiness only 57%. Jobs filled 29%. Jobs filled 29% is horrible. That is something we need to raise up. A lot of it's going to go into energy. Energy always seems to suck up all the employees you can possibly get. So let's go with speed 2. I think we're going to run out of food here. Let's see how much food is in this one. 45. Let's go ahead and pause it. How much nanites do we need to build a construction drone? 10 nanites. Well, we might be able to do that. We might be able to do 10 nanites if we get him in time. Come over here and snag that cargo pod. 45 corn, 27 rice would be more than we have right now on food. And it might give us that little boost that we need to get through the winter and, you know, get our people going, get our people doing what they need to do. We need 10. Man. You know, we still have to build a road a little further out too, because I don't think that's going to reach. So we might need something like 14 or 16 nanites to get out there. And we're at 56 food already. Let's see, are we getting more people in here? 34% of the jobs filled. We got 32 people maximum. We got 19 colonists. So they did drop off 3 new colonists there. 3 new ones. Where did they go? Did they go over here? Okay, we got a second guy in there. Second girl, I should say, again. 2 girls in there. 32% efficiency. How much are they growing? Let's see, 2.4 melons per hour. And how much do we need? So we're losing just a tiny bit. Thankfully, it's not winter anymore, and we're not losing that. So what we really need is another farm if we can get more people in. How much are they? No, we're not going to do that. We're going to go with the little plan that we had earlier, which is try to get further out there and see if we can get that built. There we go. Construction drone. Let's see. If we put that here, it will reach. It's not the most efficient, but we're going to do it because we need that food as soon as we can get it. 56 is way, way too dangerous. This is going to buy me a little bit more time. And like I said, all I need is more people. More people will make this more efficient, will make my nanites more efficient, will make everything here more efficient. And so you got to concentrate on the most valuable resource for you and people. At the very beginning of the game, even later on in the game, people always seem to be like the slowest thing to get in. And I usually build 2 immigration centers just so I can have a steady supply. And you can have a close to a max, I think, of 9 people coming in on each center. So 18 people every few minutes still usually is not fast enough, but it is, it's doable. So I hope this is close. Yeah, we got somebody already in there. Let's go ahead and pick that up. And that's going to make them a little bit happier, just a tiny bit. Let's see, how many more people do we have? 22 colonists in, 36 of jobs filled. Still only 2 people in this one, so we need to get more people. Let's see, 11 out of 16 are ready, so we need to build more habitats. Let's see, 32 nanites to build a habitat. Well, I think we're going to go with the habitat rather than going with an apartment, because it's 16 is just too low. It's just not enough. It doesn't make it worthwhile. So let's put this here. I'm going to put it as close to it as possible. I know it eats up a little bit of farming area, but we got plenty of it. And I plan to put a lot of farms way out here. We also have the iron deposit. I haven't forgotten about it, but we just don't have the resources to go out there and get it right now. So not really a high priority. And then I want to build another farm when at all possible. And those were 21 nanites. So hopefully that doesn't take too long. Let's see. Cargo pod acquired. Okay, we got low warning on food. And then immigration vessel dock, 3 more immigrants came in. So we got a total of 22 people. And you are done for the day. Okay, I see how it is. Let's see, 5, 6 immigrate are going into there. We're losing some people into this one. This one, we lost a few people as well. They went over and stayed in some different buildings. It does seem like they shift around depending on where their job is located. So they want to be somewhat close by. It's the same thing as in real life. If you're not close by to your job, you know, the trip can just be awful, and there's no traffic, I don't think, in this station. But let's actually take a look at that while we wait.
Hey, what's up?
Hola.
We can see how happy they are as soon as we can click on one.
Hey, Governor, I'm happy to be here.
Okay, so they're still somewhat happy. They're not being too complainy yet, and that's gonna be coming here pretty soon, though. Let's see, 25 people. Yeah, it's going up. It's going up. Let's see how many people we got in here. 50% efficiency. We got another person. 3.6 melons. still not enough. And of course, winter is going to be coming here pretty soon. And when that happens, you got to have a nice reserve. Otherwise, yeah, people are going to start dying. Winter warning. I knew it. Not getting them in fast. Oh, come on. We don't need as many over here in the iron mines. I mean, I'd love to have the nanites, but not that much. Let's see. 45 iron in there. We could process. Is it paused? Yeah, it's paused. Let's keep going. Winter warning and low food. Let's go to 2 speed. We actually are making a little bit of food here. We're making more food than we're losing. No, actually, we're not. Look at that. It says +2, but... Or point +2. We're maintaining, I guess. Barely. Just barely maintaining it. So we need more people, and we need another one of these. Oh, man, that's rough. We could always go with the farm. I don't like farms. They don't grow anything during the winter, and they don't really grow very much during the summer either until you upgrade them quite a bit. And if you're going to upgrade these, you might as well just go with a greenhouse. They work during the winter and the summer, and they tend to be a whole lot better for you. So let's see. 6.5 melons. Yes, please. We don't have enough for the roads just yet. We need 4 total to be able to get up there. Doesn't matter if we build it now or in a second. We only have so many little guys to go out there and do their thing, and they got to build it one piece at a time, so we'll give them a little bit of time to do that. There we go. That should help out a little bit. Now we have room for people, and we have places for people to work to get more food, and if we can get the people in fast enough, we should be ready to go. As long as they don't start clamoring for... their entertainment. We want entertainment. We're starving, but we want entertainment. It can be a little ridiculous. 4.7 food per colonist. Let's see. Immigration. 5 people coming in. Okay, so we got another worker here, which made it 5. Lives in a habitat. Let's see. Where do you live? They both live in habitats. Happiness is 69%. They still have food. They still have candy. Candy is kind of nice. I guess they got that from that quest. Let's see. What else is over here? Show notifications. Hide notifications. Okay, we don't really need to do that just yet. Yes, I get it. We're low on food. We're gonna get there, I promise. I promise you guys. Just give me a little bit more time. 30 colonists. Let's go a little bit faster. Hopefully we can get through this. We're only down 1.1, which shouldn't eat up too much of our food. Remember, we're still on rationing. So the moment we take ourselves off of rationing, that number will jack up to probably around 7 or 8. On the negative side. So we need to be a lot higher before we take ourselves off of that. Probably 3 of these greenhouses, preferably at least halfway filled up with employees. Let's see, immigration. We got 5 more people. Warning, low food. Come on, guys. I know you want to go work in the food station. You guys don't want to die, do you? They're going to work probably anywhere else but the food station. How much do we have? 56. So the very first building I want to upgrade is this one. Let's go ahead and upgrade that. The faster this is, the more nanites I have, and the better off we're gonna be. Can we upgrade? No, we can't upgrade the immigration center. I could put another one down, but somebody still has to work there. We might do that. We might go with another immigration center, actually, guys. Kind of hate to waste the resources on it, because I know I'm gonna get hit with something here in a minute. There they go. They're already complaining about food. Unbelievable. You guys got to give me some time. Give me some time. 9 nanites. Let's upgrade that. At least that will produce a little bit more food a little faster with the amount of workers they already have rather than building another one. And I'll go ahead and upgrade this one as soon as I have the 9 nanites as well. There we go. We're in the plus. We're in the plus. Now we have 2 immigration centers. People are going to be coming in nonstop. Remember, you can always turn these things off. You can shut them down if this, later down the road you decide that too many people are coming in. You don't really need them. Warning, low food. I get it, guys. I get it. We got warning, low food. Now, what do we want? Food. Where is the sign? There we go. We want food. I love how somebody has to make that holographic sign just so they can protest. Oh, man. They all want food. They are not happy campers. Okay, I'm going to get this up to about 500, and then I'm going to take rationing off so that they might be a little happier on their food scale. But we need that food to last through the winter, and I don't think 200 or even 300 is going to be enough for that. Zoom out a little bit. We got 49% efficiency on this one. 41% efficiency on that one. We are producing more melons on this one than we are the other one. Actually, no, we're not. 8.5 melons on this one versus the 5 melons on that one. Okay, so we finished off quite a few quests here. You can see it right here. Immigration vessel docked for 4 people. 5 immigrations. Let's see. Completing food income. So we finished off that quest. Geothermal energy we finished off. Apartment we finished off. And immigration we finished off. Let's check out the nuclear quest we got.
Could benefit from increased storage capacity.
Okay, so they want a storage depot. Let's go ahead and turn off rationing. And I think we have enough. Actually, let's slow it down a little bit. Let's put it on pause for a second. Trade hub, immigration. Let's do storage. Because I think our storage is completely filled up, right? Yep. We could do mini storage, or we could go with regular. I think we're going to go with regular, although I'm pretty sure they want mini. That's usually what they go with. Let's do it right over here, and we'll put down a road to go with it. We'll put an extra one down just in case. Go to play.
We have some thoughts on how to best expand your colony.
All right. In order to expand, we're going to need more nanites faster. We would like you to increase nanite income to at least 1.5 per hour. Be aware that the iron deposits here are not as rich in mineral as the other regions of Aven Prime. You will need to carefully plan the expansion of your colony to reach the other... we already knew that. Let's see. I think what we're going to do with that is come around the side and come over here and snag this one. This will definitely increase the amount of processing we have. At the same time, I won't have to upgrade these, which I know I'm going to get rid of anyways. So let's see. Storage. We need 12 nanites to do the small one. So I'll do both. I'll do the big one and the small one because I want a lot of food, and that always takes up a lot of space. So does water. Water takes up a lot of space. You can already see 784 on our water. But more importantly, as we build these greenhouses, they require water too. 1.4 on that water usage, 2.2 water usage on that one. So yeah, that's definitely going to come in handy. We're going to need to start worrying about clean air here in a bit. You can see it's been going down. It starts at 100. Once it gets around 68, 65, that's when they start complaining. Yep, there they go, complaining about air quality. Poor immigration. I get it, guys. I know what you need. I just don't have the time to give it to you. You guys want too much too quickly. Let's do one here, and then we are going to put down some clean air places just because we got to. Let's see, clean air. What do we got? Intake fan. I don't like those. We're going to try to go with the air filters and see if we can manage that, because we got too many geothermal vents way too far away from us. And the moment those things start erupting all that green goo gas stuff, our colony is going to get just, yeah, it's going to be nasty. So going with these will definitely be a better option, I think, in the long run. So let's put one down there. I think I'm going to leave a road to go across right there. I think will be the best method. And we still need to put one over here. These mines over here definitely make things dirty, so.
What do we want? No.
Yeah. Listen to that voice.
What do we want? No pollution!
I don't think I've heard them say that before as far as that voice goes. Air quality alert, I get it, 7 immigrants. We completed habitation, and we got 7 more immigrants. We completed storage, and
well
we got
done.
A reward.
I'm pleased with the progress of your colony. You may select one of the following resources.
We're going to go with nanites on this one. We have plenty of food at the moment, and immigrants are coming in 2 at a time, so we need more of this. Let's see, let's do it right here. Yep, that's going to work right there. And we may put down one more somewhere. But remember, it does take a while for that to filter in. Maybe over here would be a good spot. Somewhere along that path. I could put down another one over here, too. Let's put a road right there. And we'll put down a clean air filter. 26 nanites, we're almost there. How are you doing, man? 117, so not too hot. I need another one of you somewhere on here. And then after we get to that point, we might have to put down one or two police stations and maybe a entertainment system of some sort, and then we need to start concentrating on creating our chemical sludge. You can see crime level low, very low. There's a little bit of room right here where things can get pretty bad. Let's see, happiness. Oof, happiness is already horrible. And we do still have to win our first election. Let's see, insufficient power, nice. Of course, insufficient power. Let's see, how much do we need? 12 nanites. Upgrade, please. upgrade quickly. Insufficient housing. Oh, great. And you're destroying roads already. I don't have the money to start fixing this stuff. Insufficient power. I get it. Air quality alert. More immigrants coming in. Objective complete on the cargoes. We need to do one more processing plant. Where are you at? Nanite processor 14. 14, 14. Almost there. Almost there. Come on, guys. I know you can do it. Let's see. Air quality is still not good enough, so I may have to upgrade some of those. Over here, I definitely need to put one down, though. That's not what I wanted to do yet. Let's do this one here. And let's see if we can upgrade these. These are probably not too expensive, right? 7 nanites. So we can upgrade that one. We'll upgrade this one. 7 more nanites. And once this thing is down, we'll definitely want to upgrade this one first. How much is that? Cannot afford to upgrade. Nanite processor is 8 nanites. So we'll snag that one. That's going to help us create more nanites faster since we have plenty of them. You can see it in this one right here. We have 129 just sitting in there. These are about to run out, I imagine. Let's see what's in there. 57 iron, 94 iron, and we have over here 37. What do they want? Unbelievable. You guys already want entertainment. You guys are a bunch of pigs. Bunch of pigs.
I'd like to recommend that you increase the amount of residential space in your colony.
All right, so they want us to build another apartment. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. I guess we can do that. Let's put it right over here. I was going to save that for a 4-slot building. I guess we still can. A 4-slot building right there might still fit in. Air quality still not good enough. Still not good enough. Over here, it's just never going to be good enough unless I put one down. So let's go with... Let's go with something cheap. I didn't really want to put it down, but I'm not wasting 26 nanites on this guy's over here, especially with them wanting all of the stuff that they want right now. And I need to put down a research center immediately so we can start getting that done. Where is the research center? Where is it at? In there? There we go. Research center. 64 nanites. Holy crap.
A new mission is available.
We need a bit more electricity to sustain the colony's extension. Make sure the colony has at least 4 solar panels. So we need to build 2 more solar panels. And how much are you going to give me for that? 6 nanites? That's not going to cover it, but it's not too bad. And it may lead to something better. Air quality, yeah. Get it. You guys are a bunch of piggies. How are you guys doing? So this air over here is the least clean. Everything else is getting clean bit by bit. Lower crime. Quick crime. Oh, there is a little bit. There is a little bit. But I am not building that yet. I'm building the research center. That is final, guys. It's final. They're gonna riot in the street and be like, you get your research center. But you don't have any citizens. Ugh, I don't know where to build it, though. Over here, maybe? This might be a good spot. Kind of way out in the boonies. There we go. Oh, my God. That was expensive. Okay, let's see. We need to do 2 more of these. Let's do one here. And we'll do another one right over here on this side as soon as it's done. And they're right. I do need electricity. I mean, you know, our electricity needs are right there on the line. We're at 237 out of 246. And at winter, it's going to be 227. So we're going to not be within range of what we need to be during winter time. So that is not going to hold out. And I don't think we have another... Yeah, we don't have another one of those anywhere near us. We have to go out towards this one over here or that one over there. And that's a little bit further out than I wanted to go. But I think we're going to have to do it. I think we're going to have to do it whether we want to or not. Because this thing right here is going to eat through my energy really, really badly. So let's start working our way as far out as we can go. I can't build the stuff they want me to build because I have no energy to do it. Let's do this guy right here. I still don't think that's going to be enough to get over here, but it is going to give me some nanites and some gold and some bread, so that's the direction I'm going right now. What else do we have? We have any resources over here? No, not for a while. 450 in that direction. 267 there. Oh, we're going to run out any minute, guys. Any minute. Let's go ahead and look at our research. Let's go ahead and pause it real quick. We need to do Calcul Sludge, and we'll do all the other ones, because why not? Not that it's really going to help us out too much. I don't think we got our research or our thing done in time.
A new mission is available.
All right, the geothermal generator and mines in particular will begin to pollute the air without intake fans or air filters. As your colony extends outwards, placing these air quality structures will become increasingly more important. Build two intake fans where they are needed most. Well, we already have one there, so that's kind of already halfway done.
I have a request for you from the inhabitants of the colony.
And she wants more people. Let's see, insufficient housing? Really? Well, I don't really care about insufficient housing right now. 67% of people are at work. Oh man, I guess we can do a little bit of housing. We can upgrade that for 20 nanites. So yeah, let's go ahead and do that. Let's hit play. Let's see. I guess that's going to be close enough to this guy over here. I'm hoping so. Probably still have to build one more housing out there. Let's see. What is this? Minerals exhausted. Let's see. Select. Yeah, that one is gone now, so let's go ahead and recycle this. That will give me those employees back so I can use them on other things. Let's go with two on the speed. Let's see, winter is coming, fast approaching. Is our power going to hold out? 257 power supply in the winter will be 286, so we should be okay. Should be okay, because we got rid of this one little building over here, so that should lower it for us. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're going to have to go for power over anything else, and I don't think we're gonna get there. Yeah, we're not. We're gonna get right next to it, but we're not gonna quite do it. Yeah, no drones in area. Let's do this one right there, and we might have to put a housing out there. Let's do an apartment right next to it. I can't believe I'm doing this even though my energy is running out. 30 iron recoverable. Let's see, 251. How much energy do I have? Not enough. Not enough. And we still need to build. Let's go ahead and do that before we get too far out there. Just in case things do go bad, I can always get rid of some of their food and kind of balance it back and forth. We need a chemical plant. So 44 nanites. 44 nanites, I will build this, and we will have that to work with. Let's do this right here. And hopefully, when this one runs out, I'll be able to recycle that, get a little bit of nanites back from that one, and of course you're gonna start trolling me with the lightning already. Stop it, guys! I don't have enough nanites. I might actually get rid of some of my buildings here. Insufficient power. Why is there insufficient power? Did you destroy something you're not supposed to? Immigration center lost power. I'm fine with that. I'm actually more than fine with that at the moment. Let's see, have you guys gotten people over here? Yes, you have. So let's go with energy, and we'll see how much we can get down here. Right there, we'll snag this as well. And you guys destroyed something, didn't you? Ah, you destroyed something again. Slow it down. All right. You destroyed that same road twice. And then you destroyed the main line over here, so nothing's getting through. New mission.
I hope you're keeping the happiness of your colonists in mind as you grow your colony. Remember, we're all in this together.
We still have to win a referendum. Low water. Oh, you guys suck so bad. So bad. I don't have the resources to waste. Stop hitting me with that. Water is not low. You guys are ridiculous. You still have 900 water. When it's low and you're running out of water to drink, then I will do something for you. Until then, not a priority. What do you want? Lower crime. That ain't happening. Not anytime soon, guys. Sorry. That is a long, long way off. Okay, so we need to start making farms. So let's go ahead and look at where we can put the farming areas. Let's see. Water, commute, crime, employment, housing, happiness, resources. I don't actually see crops. There we go. And we want to enable. We want the spores. Where's a good spot for it? Of course, destroy another road for me, please. Maybe over here? Then not very good. This is not a great spot to build those. That kind of sucks. Okay, well, we're going to have to make do with where we can put it, I think. And you are damaged. 22 nanites to repair that? Ugh. Okay, well, we're going to build the farms first. Let's get a few of these. We're going to do two green or tier two greenhouse. Let's see, 5.1 during the winter. That's not too terribly bad. 5.5. We'll do that one there. We'll do one more. Six. Yeah, that's good. I think that will be a decent amount if we can get workers in there to do what we need it to do. Let's see, building broken, cargo pod acquired, warning low water, immigration vessel docked, minerals exhausted. Okay, so this is the one that's minerals exhausted. Let's recycle that. We won't lose out on the food or the people anymore. Water, you're still good. Research complete. Okay. Research is complete. That means these things, these nanite processors, will start processing the Kelcoal sludge as soon as there's some there to process. These guys just have to get in there and build it. Okay, we got people in there. They're making 1.8 per hour, 2.2. So it is going up. Let's go ahead and repair this building. Okay, so they want a lot of stuff. I'm going to give them some police, at least just one, to help out. Let's go ahead and take that down. I know where it needs to go already. Police, police, police. Scrubbers, no, not yet. Oh, don't tell me it free. Oh, okay, there it goes. Okay, so it just paused for a second. I don't know what it was thinking. Let's do police right here. Yeah, we'll do police right there. It's down on the bottom. They're going to roam all over anyways. It's not too big of a deal. Water, you're still low. I get it. Let's go this way. We'll put another police station up here as well. And then I think we'll put down some entertainment system. Lower crime. Yeah, that's the one thing they want more than anything else. So we'll give them that. Police station, maybe out here. I mean, this one's going to run out pretty soon. And once it does, I can build that road straight down. I still have to build one more intake van. But I'm not really too worried about that. Maybe out here. Let's put the intake fan here. Air intake fan right next to it. We'll move that down the road. Let's see. Air quality alert. Yep. All the way out there, isn't it? Mm-hmm. That's where it's going down. And it does affect everybody. It doesn't matter if they live in that area or not. As long as they work in that area or that area is being affected.
The Constitution guarantees your citizens the right to vote on their colony governor. It looks like that time is upon us again.
Yeah, it's a good thing I started pulling the police stations down. Probably not in time, though. They're not going to be happy. Yeah, look at that crime. What do they want?
What do we want? Entertainment!
Aw, come on. Entertainment already? Okay, let's see. What can I build them? Retail center, by far, is the most valuable thing for you. They're going to love that crap if you can build one. But, you know, 38 nanites is kind of costly. Hospitals are nice. They don't really require those. Those are things you can do down the road. VR center will unlock the ability so you can actually have more.
Well done. I'm pleased with the progress of your colony.
Going with nanites.
You may select one of the following resources.
Going with nanites. That's a dead giveaway right there. 38. Come on. We just need one more. One more. Come on, guys. You can do it. Here we go. Let's put it down. I think that's within everybody's reach. And that should give them a decent amount of happiness. Now, my water has been slowly trickling down. So I do think I need to put one more down somewhere eventually. But I'm not in too big of a rush to do that. Objective complete. So we finish that one. Increased storage. Insufficient housing. So we can upgrade our housing. Six more immigrants. Objective complete. Water level.
A new mission is available.
The next step is to build a trade hub to allow you to exchange resources with the orbiting colony. That might be really, really useful, actually. So we'll do that when we can, but we need 20 nanites for this. Let's look at water. What do we need for water? We could actually just upgrade the one we have, but might as well put one down and just get a little bit more water going. I think I usually only have two. The entertainment's being built. Give it a second, guys. You know it's coming. You know, you can see it. You drive down the road, you see it over there, and you're like, oh, that's going to be cool when it's open. Oh, they crack me up, man. This game is very difficult when you put it on insane. Of course, you know, that goes without saying. Insane mode is supposed to be a challenge, but the fact that they want entertainment, you know, right off the bat is just, it gets you, man. It just makes you kind of chuckle a little bit when they're out there protesting for it. Put a big sign out there. Can you imagine? That's a first world problem right there. We want entertainment. We got food. We got luxuries. We just want our entertainment. We want to be happy. I can't blame them, but at the same time, it's, yeah, a little weird. Now, I can upgrade these. One of them anyways, I think. No, I did upgrade both of those already, so I might have to put down another food venue, because it does look like our colony population has expanded quite a bit. We're already 118 maximum capacity until we upgrade this with 20 nanites, and we're not getting there anytime soon. Let's see. You guys are not making sludge, huh? Let's, oh, you know what? I put down the factory, but I never told it what to make. I am a complete idiot. Okay, let's see. Chemical plant? Is that not, did I build the wrong one? Is it a mill? I thought it was the, oh, man, don't tell me I'm wrong, because if I am, I'm gonna be out of luck here. Let me see. Did they do the right research? They haven't done chemical sludge yet. Oh, come on. Let's do chemical sludge. We need that one before anything else. I thought they do it in the order you click it, but they haven't, and...
Hi, boss. I've compiled some feedback to help guide you in the upcoming referendum election.
All right, 62% of the vote. You need... I need a place I can go and have some fun. I have to walk too far to my job. There's no place to buy what I need. Well, this thing is done now, and it has plenty of people working there, so a lot of that stuff should change. Come on, baby. Oh, God, I can't believe I got that one wrong. Okay, immigration vessel, warning, gal, water, research complete. Okay, so... Every single time I've ever used the research thing, the very first one you push is the one they do. And the one time I need it the most is when they change it up on you. So yeah, that just goes to without showing. You gotta watch things. You gotta make sure you're paying attention to everything. Let's go ahead and look at police. Police have kept crime pretty low. Out there will be an issue eventually because it's way, way far away. Let's look at air quality, 75. That's not great. We do need to upgrade that at some point to better facilities. Let's look at happiness. Happiness is on the rise. There's a few places a little bit outside of our range, like these guys out here. They're going to need a bar and grill or something to keep them a little bit happier than the rest of everybody else. Let's see. Are you still not done? 20, 30%? Let's go with speed 2. Can't really do anything until that's done. Actually, I can upgrade my housing, so let's go ahead and do that. It's going to require more food, though, unfortunately, and we're already pretty low on it. How are you guys doing? 3.1 per hour, 3.7 per hour. Let's look in our storage. How much do we have? 558 already, 561. The good thing about that is once our plant can start processing it, it processes it really, really quickly. Atmospheric condenser, no, that's not important. We're going to go with another food place. We'll go with the greenhouse 1. Oh, no, it's only 30. It's only like another 9 more. We'll go with the greenhouse 2, and we'll put down some more melons. I hope they like melons because they're going to be eating them for a long, long time to come. Are you done yet? No, 64%. This guy is the slowest ever. We're at 398 on our electricity, so we're going to have to upgrade this pretty soon as well, and that's going to cost us 12 nanites. Ugh, okay, well, it is what it is. It's just another thing we have to be aware of. Don't know where I'm going to find all these nanites. This is, we get more people in. 65% of jobs filled. That's good, at least. We are being a little bit more efficient.
There's a referendum election coming up soon, and I have some feedback from your colonists.
It doesn't have enough tunnels to help me get around. I miss the shopping centers. There's a shopping center right here. Retail center right there. I guess I might have to put another one out there, but that's it's a long, long way off from even being remotely happening. There we go, 97, 98, come on, 99, done. All right, let's go ahead and tell them to do the sludge and tell these guys to do some more stuff. In this order, it doesn't really matter. I don't really use any of the other stuff. I could use some of the stimulants to make them work faster, but I don't have any of the resources, so we're going to forget that. Water level still low. Actually, it's getting really low, so let's go ahead and upgrade one of these. 8 nanites on that one. Where's the other one? Mini storage, water pump. Let's upgrade that one. It's the farming that we're putting down. Incoming shard storm. No, no, no. We haven't won the referendum yet. If we win that, we can use the auto repair drones, and it doesn't cost me anything. This is going to cost me stuff, and I don't have the resources. Let's see. Incoming shards, immigration vessel, insufficient housing, research complete, immigration. Okay. Ah, oh, man, I don't have the money. 16 is all I got, and I'm barely breaking even on the water. So I still have to build a water facility in here somewhere else to help that go a little faster. Oh, great. Here we go. Research and my housing. My housing seems to be very, very vulnerable. That's 10 nanites on that one. Storage depot. We got a solar reactor that needs to be repaired. 1 nanite on that one. Immigration. I think I might even get rid of that one down the road, so I'm going to leave that one alone for now. Let's repair this. 10 nanites to repair that one. That's not good. That's a little bit outside of our range at the moment. There we go. Our water is back up to 11.6. So let's go ahead and repair that. It's going to leave us with nothing. Nothing left. Those are both going to get repaired. And we still have to build a farm. You can see our food is slowly dwindling down. That's not good. Let's see. Are you guys using the sludge yet? You are. Okay, so 140. They're processing it. This one over here, where did I put the other one? Right here. And he's leveled out as well. Yeah, wintertime. Wintertime is going to lower my food even further. Warning, low-level food, low water, insufficient housing, and vessel docked. Okay, so the water is going up. Food is going down. And I am slowly creating more sludge. This one still has 130 left. 130 there. We could get out here and get one more. This one has 450. It is within our range to get. That would be one, two, maybe three.
And they've given me some feedback that might help you.
That really sounds like Halle Berry right there, is all I gotta say, guys. No, nobody's ever replied back on whether you guys think that is her or not. I could always look it up, but I like to guess when I play these games and just see if I can spot the voices. And I know some big actors, they do the video game, so that could definitely be a thing. Impending structure, we're not worried about that. Low level in water. It's going up. It's going up. Just leave it alone for now. How's my power? On the skirts of running out. Low-level food. You know, I know about it. I can't do anything about it yet. I'm just waiting. Oh, man. These insane ones. The first episode, getting these things started, they get to you, man. And then you're like, once you finally get there, and you have a foothold, things become so much better. So much, a lot less complaining, a lot less like, oh, people want this, people want that. You don't really get that too much. Let's go ahead and repair this. I'm not doing it. I'm not doing that. I'd rather just recycle it. Let's recycle the immigration center. Get some of our resources back on it. Low-level food, vessel docked, insufficient housing, water level. Let's see, what do we have here? Habitat is 66 out of 66, so that is completely filled up. And now we can put down another building, so let's go ahead and change that to melons. Really? Only 5 there? What is it up here? Oh, look at that. 12.4. That is where that one's going. A little further out, which means they're not going to be too happy on the route that they have to take, but so be it if I can get twice as much from it. Water, warning, low-level food, research complete. How are you guys doing? How much you got in there? 420, 440? Are you processing it fast enough? 420, 440. It seems like they're staying even. And you guys are just going to destroy some of my roads now. Lightning center. Let's go ahead. Insufficient housing. Warning. I really wish they would stop popping up once you already know about it. Let's see. How much would it cost to do them here? 6.5. 6. 7.8, 7.5. Let's do one more food right there, because we can always change it down the road if we need to. Lightning strike, and you destroyed that same road. Does not like this one right here. This is a very good spot for wasting my resources. And if my research center wasn't down here, I would just move that road. I'd put something else there, like a building, and put a road around it, but That's gonna be a ways off. Okay, 667. We finally are in the green, and everything is working pretty good, right? How's my sludge doing? 600 sludge? Oh wow, it has plenty of sludge to process. These things aren't processing them fast enough.
Congratulations on your referendum victory, boss.
Nice. Okay, before any more lightning strikes, we are going down there. Auto repair drones, please. Forced overtime. Ugh. You know, I want to do it, but at the same time, I don't think we can. That's a little too expensive. Okay, let's go ahead and repair this. Oh, man. These are going to have to be manually repaired too, aren't they? Let's see if the drones will go out there and do it for me. But I don't think they will. Let's go ahead and give myself a little bit more energy. Drones, will you go to work? No, doesn't seem like they will. We got a new mission here.
I have a request for you from the inhabitants of the colony.
All right, so congratulations on winning the referendum. They want us to build a skyscraper. Insufficient housing. Okay, so they are repairing it for me, and they're not using any of this. Oh, man, I got to build a skyscraper now? Ugh, I don't know if we can do that yet. Let's see, how much are you guys doing? Not enough, so I can upgrade you. Let's go ahead and do that. We're going to build maybe one or two more nanite processors. Probably just one for now. We don't really want to waste any more resources than that if we don't have to. Where do I put them, though? That's a good question. I guess we can put them down here in this one little spot. Let's do that. Nanite processors are 14 apiece. That's not too bad. Let's see. What are we making over here on our nanites? 880. And as this one gets upgraded, as that plant gets upgraded, they're just going to be using more and more of them. So let's go ahead and put that one down. We'll put down one more, I think. And a total of four. I'm hoping that's going to be enough. I really do, because I don't want to put down more than four. In fact, I'll still have these two that I can upgrade if the time is right for it. Now, these never really go out of style. No matter what you do, you're always going to be processing nanites in some way, whether it's from iron, whether it's from copper, or the sludge. So these are okay to upgrade all the way to the max, even at the very beginning, if what you need to do. The mines, on the other hand, these drills, you can see this one's almost done, and I didn't upgrade it at all, so... In fact, it's actually kind of nice, because if it had upgraded, it would have been mining it faster, and I would have used those resources for probably stuff that I didn't need to, and then I wouldn't have had it when I needed it, so I am okay with that. Let's see, this one is 1K on the sludge. Okay, 1K on the sludge is getting upgraded. 400, 500 is okay with me. 1,000, that's a little excessive to have that just kind of sitting in there, not making any nanites, especially when I have so many things I need to do. I need to upgrade my police drones. I need to get some more entertainment systems down. You can see they're happy over here somewhat, not happy over there even remotely. The air quality still needs to be improved quite a bit. Housing needs to be fixed. There's just not enough housing to go around. There's no more people that can come in. And so that is just, it's hampering my ability to continue a lot. And we need 66 nanites for a skyscraper. We also still have to build a trade hub for 36 nanites. So those are just really, really costly stuff. Let's click off of these. 61% of jobs filled. So I think the very first thing I do is build a skyscraper. Let's see. Insufficient housing. I get it, guys. I get it. Food. Food is good. 8.7. That's not bad. Water is way more than I really need. Let's see. We might have to build another one of these down the road so that I can do antibiotics. But right now, I want the sludge more than anything else. I'm not even worried about antibiotics. I don't even have a hospital yet, but it is something that, you know, I got to plan for at some point. So 20 nanites to work with. We need 66 nanites and 38 power. 38 power. That's not going to be enough. We don't have enough power to do that. Oh, man. Don't tell me I got to work all the way over there. We might be able to reach this one. Let's see if we can reach this one. Nope, not quite. So we need to put down another drone. Let's do a drone right here. And then we should be able to reach that one right there. Oh, no. Look at that. Here comes the hailstorm, guys. I love the trees, though. Look at that. They have little spots on them. Almost a little neon kind of look to it. That's very, very beautiful. Oh no, how much damage are you causing? I don't care, I'm not repairing it. My little drones will do it. Get to work, guys, get to work. You got stuff to do. So my retail center, that took some damage. 56% efficiency, 54% efficiency. You guys are still coming out here. 19 nanites. So 19 nanites. And I still have to build the geothermal generator, and I got to save up to build the vent and an apartment out here. And then I can build the skyscraper. So it's always something. Always something kind of slowing you down, stopping you from going any further. No power construction to the drone. You guys are slow. You guys need to speed that up. How are you guys doing? You still haven't upgraded that. You still haven't repaired that, huh? How are you guys doing in here? 1K sludge. They're maintaining. They're maintaining that 1K. If I get more people, that will slowly trickle down. I think they got space in there. And the same thing on the other guys. They got space in theirs. Where is it at? Yeah, they got two spaces in theirs. Two spaces in theirs. Let's see. Anybody in there? Nobody is in there yet. Oh, man. You're destroying stuff. Oh, no. That's my lifeline to my energy. Get that going. What did you guys destroy over here? That same road? Yeah, no, it's one road down. Or actually, I think they destroyed both roads here. So let's get that in there. Water levels are dropping because of it. Insufficient housing. Immigration. Can't acquire workers to the drone because there are no workers who live nearby. So we are going to have to put a housing unit out here. Let's go with... it's 18, 32 nanites. Let's go with... it's 18 nanites for that one. 66 nanites. We're almost to 66, so might as well just wait and go with a 66 nanite one up here on the front. I know it's not going to be enough power, and it's wintertime, and you know it's going to cause all sorts of issues, but you know, if I'm going to spend the resources, and it has to be close to this thing anyways, then I'm just going to put that down. I will get the resources that you get from this one, 7 nanites, 18 candy, and it should only be for a limited time. Let's actually go ahead and save the episode here. See if it will let us. There we go. And name it A1 for steak sauce. Now, I have no idea, just something random. Guys, I think we're going to go ahead and stop it here. I do want to thank you guys for watching. If you do enjoy these episodes, definitely leave those comments down below. Like I said before, we will be doing Sandbox after we go through this map and one more map, and then we will be going back. So leave your vote on which one you would like to see me go through and build to its biggest. Remember, at the very beginning, the first 1 to 2 episodes is when all that hecticness is kind of in there. You got to do a lot of stuff, and you got to do it in the right order. But after that is done, that's when you can sit back, you can relax, and you can just be like, what do I want to build, and how beautiful can I make the city? Let me redesign. Let me just recycle everything that I need that space for and build giant skyscrapers instead of little tiny apartments. That is definitely... Hey guys, and welcome to the disembodied voice of AC Gamer. We are definitely going to be doing a lot more series in the future, but here are a few of them that you guys might find interesting. Of course, you're more than welcome to check them out. I would love to hear your comments. Again, if you do enjoy these videos, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe. It's definitely the indicator that I use to tell if you guys want to see more videos like that, of that particular game style, of that series in the long run. So when you guys leave comments down, it helps me decide whether we should keep doing it, as well as whether you want to see games like that in the future. And here are a few of them right here. I kind of picked out a few of different genres. We will be doing spotlights for other YouTubers in the future. So if you want to get a little shout out, definitely let me know. If you group with me, chances are you will get a shout out in here eventually. But for now, these are just 4 series that I have that I feel like could use a little bit more attention, and that you guys might actually enjoy as well. Thanks again for watching, guys, and we will definitely catch you all next time.